Defending the Earth.
That's right, the next few episodes of Random Space Factor are going to focus on defending the Earth from asteroid impact. I'm going to tell you the Planetary Society's five-step plan for
defending the Earth.
Every day, more than 100 tons of dust and sand-sized material hits the Earth's atmosphere. 100 tons. It's that dust that causes the streaks of light we call meteors. But there's bigger stuff out there. Asteroids and comets. The asteroids and comets that come near Earth's orbit we call near-Earth objects, or NEOs. The good news is, big asteroids do not hit Earth very often, but they do hit. In 2013, an asteroid about the size of a big house exploded in the atmosphere above Chelyabinsk, Russia, causing a shockwave that shattered windows and injured more than 1,000 people. In 1908, a 40-meter asteroid exploded in the atmosphere above Siberia. It leveled part of a forest. Trees were knocked down in an area 50% bigger than the city of Los Angeles. 50,000 years ago, a 50-meter asteroid hit what is now Arizona. It left a 1 kilometer hole in the ground. And of course, 65 million years ago, a city-sized asteroid hit what is now Mexico. That impact led to the extinction of 70% of all species on Earth and the extinction of the ancient dinosaurs. So clearly, asteroids do hit, but they don't hit often, and big ones don't hit as often as small ones. This is not a danger we need to lose sleep over, but we do need to do something about it. It is the only large-scale natural disaster we can prevent if we properly utilize our space programs. Remember, the dinosaurs didn't have a space program. I mean, if they did, well, they could have done something. Hey, be sure to watch our next episodes in this series of the five-step plan to prevent asteroid impact.